Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to our last session of the industrial control course. And we're going to look at the simulation of what we have seen so far, which is the application of direct and indirect control in pneumatic circuits. So the first simulation that I'm going to share with you is using a software called FluidSim. It's called FluidSim, or fluid simulation stands for fluid simulation. Fluid is actually referring to compressed air or even fluid refers to hydraulics. Okay, so fluid refers to compressed air, which is also called pneumatics or hydraulics. So hence the name FluidSim. So this is software which is available. You could purchase the software to run the simulation. So let us go to the simulation of a direct control system. So here we have the simulator environment, where we have already set up the components and the connections as shown in the slide. So I'm going to start and hit the run button. So you can see that the lines are highlighted with dark blue, showing that the air or the compressed air is already available at this line, whereas the light blue indicates that the compressed air has not reached this line. So why is that? Because the on-off button is in the off position. So now it is on. I'm going to off, on, off, on. Okay, so we have already switched on the on-off valve or shut-off valve. Now the compressed air is right at the blocked port of the DCV, directional control valve. And as you can see, this is a direct control circuit. Okay, so the operator is going to push onto this push button, causing the single acting cylinder to extend fully. So I'm going to release now. The spring inside the acting cylinder, single acting cylinder, causes the piston to retract or return to home position. So again, providing compressed air extends the piston, removing the compressed air causes the piston to retract. So we are done with the simulation, the direct control simulation. We are moving now next to the indirect. So again, we are having the same setup for the pressure supply, the FRL or the filter regulator lubricator circuit, and then the on-off valve. I'm going to hit the run button. Again, you can see that the dark blue indication showing that the air is actually only reaching the on-off valve. So I need to start this valve, okay, to get the supply started all the way to my valves. Okay, so once the air has reached the required valves, we need to operate. Again, this is an indirect control circuit, so the operator is only going to deal with the first layer or the first valve in the circuit, whereas the intermediate or the intermediate switching valve is going to directly deal with the single acting cylinder. So I'm going to release. So the piston goes back to home position. Activate again. Release. Activating again. Release. Okay. So just one interesting note, that the valve over here is actuated manually, whereas the valve here is actuated pneumatically. There is no human operator that pushes this valve. In fact, air that is leaving the the valve here goes all the way to actuate the intermediate switching valve. Okay, so I hope that this simple and concise description of the simulation brings the picture closer to the participant or the learner as how the circuit operates in its simulation environment. So thank you for now, and if you have any questions, please drop them at the Q&A link provided at our platform. So thank you for now, and see you later.